Good morning, student. Today I am going to discuss our next chapter, that is chapter 2, atmosphere. Atmosphere means the sphere of air, or you can say the layer of air, because sphere means layer. So our today's chapter is atmosphere. First, you write down exactly what we are going to know from this chapter. Number one, we are going to know the meaning of atmosphere. Our second topic, composition of the atmosphere and their importance. Our third topic, structure of the atmosphere. Number four, another layer, the biosphere. We are going to know the meaning of this layer. Number five, it has two parts, A and B. First, greenhouse effect. We are going to know the meaning of this word and its causes. Our next topic, number six, it has three parts. Number A, global warming. We are going to know the meaning of this word. Second, impact of global warming we will discuss. And the last, we will know ways to reduce global warming. So these are the things which one we will discuss and given in our book, part of syllabus you can say. This whole topics, number 1 to 6, I have divided into two parts. Can you see? Part 1 and part 2 I have mentioned. 1 to 4 coming under part 1 and 5 and 6 coming under part 2. What is the meaning? Meaning, this part 1, today I will discuss part 1 portion. Means, today I will discuss meaning of atmosphere, composition of the atmosphere, structure of the atmosphere and the biosphere. These four. And in our next video, I will discuss number 5 and 6, that is greenhouse effect and global warming, their causes and impact. Understood? Okay, now our first topic, meaning of atmosphere, which I think all of you know. Atmosphere means a layer of gases which surrounding our whole earth. That's why in a very short way I have written here, layer of gases surrounding the earth is called atmosphere. Or you can say that atmosphere is a blanket of air which surrounding our whole earth. Means earth has many layers. One of them is atmosphere. Or you can say it is outermost layer of our earth. Our earth is completely covered by this layer. This layer mainly consists many gases. Because our next topic, composition, I will discuss that one. That main composition of this layer is different gases. But except gases, many more things are also present. But as a meaning, we will only say that atmosphere is a layer of gases which surrounding our whole earth. Understood? Now the composition, where we will say about different gases and many more things which are present in this layer. So our next topic, composition of the atmosphere. Yes, main thing is different type of gases which are present in this layer, because you know atmosphere means mixture of gases. But except gases, two more important things are also present, and they are the composition, or you can say constituents of this layer. And these two are water vapor and dust particles. Clear? But the concentration wise, quantity wise, maximum amount is occupied by different gases. So atmosphere means different gases, but their water vapor and dust particles are also present, and they have their own importance. So all three are important. So if the question comes, what are the composition of the atmosphere, we have to write these three names. First, different gases, then water vapor, and the third, dust particles. And one by one I am going to say their importance. First, different gases. Many are there. Only four I have mentioned: nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide and ozone. Then I have written etc. Because after that we have xenon, neon, krypton, argon, many are there. But these four, concentration wise, more. So we are going to know about only these four. Nitrogen, all of you know, it has highest concentration in this layer, and the amount 78.08%. This gas is lighter than oxygen and carbon dioxide, means very light. And what is the importance of this gas? Actually, it is important for plants and small organism, because it helps. It is very important for them. It helps to grow. Done? One more importance it has. Nitrogen helps, or you can say nitrogen keeps our earth cool. I said cool, not cold. That is nitrogen. Our next one is oxygen. It has second highest concentration in this atmosphere. And the quantities, percentage wise, we can say 20.94% in this atmosphere. It is very important, all of you know the reason. That's why it is called the supporting gases. Supporting life supporting gas. Because it helps to breathe. Human beings, or you can say living organism, can survive on this planet because of this gas, one of the main reason. All are important, but main one is this one. It has another importance. That one, it is essential for combustion. And this gas, it is heavier than nitrogen, but lighter than carbon dioxide. So ultimately we can see carbon dioxide, our third one, is heavier than nitrogen and oxygen. Next, our third gas, carbon dioxide. Just now I said it is the heaviest gas in the atmosphere. Quantity wise it is very less, but very important for plants. All of you know, plants can make their own food with the help of this carbon dioxide. Done? But due to human activities, day by day, the concentration of this gas increases. So you can say it is highly variable gas, because according to the pollution, its quantity increases. Less pollution means less quantity, more pollution means more quantity. It is important for plants, but harmful for us. Our next gas, ozone. It is very important gas. It is useful, helpful. Why? Because it protects us from ultraviolet rays coming from the sun. Quantity wise, very less. And this ozone forms from oxygen. So our fourth one is ozone. This one is mainly produced by the action of the solar radiation on oxygen gas present in the atmosphere. Just now I said ozone mainly formed from oxygen. So these are the four important gases present in atmosphere, but except these four, many are there. That's why our first composition is different types of gases. But our next two are also very important, water vapor and dust particles. Water vapor is important to form rain or snow. This water vapor converts into the cloud, and the cloud brings heavy rain, and rain is very important for us, all of you know. So water vapor, which one is present in this atmosphere, one of the composition of atmosphere, and it brings, or you can say it form rain or snow. Dust particles, very minute particle, very small particle present in this atmosphere, but very important to form cloud. Just now I said water vapor responsible to bring rain. Yes, to form rain there are three different processes are present. One is evaporation, second one is condensation, and third one is precipitation. These three processes together form rain. Second one, just now I said condensation. This condensation mainly form, or you can say takes place with the help of dust particles. So dust particles is very important for condensation process. And what happened in this process? In this process, condensation process, cloud form. From water vapor we are getting cloud, from water vapor to cloud. So to develop a cloud, develop the cloud, for the formation of cloud, you can say dust particles very important. That's why it is called condensation nuclei or condensation nucleus. So these are the three important composition of atmosphere. Now our third topic, structure of the atmosphere. Atmosphere is one of the layer of earth like other layers, and this layer also divided into some layers, means we can divide atmosphere into four different layers on the basis of, I have mentioned, temperature. Yes, temperature varies. We people who are living on plain region, we can feel here temperature is high, but hill areas temperature low. So it is clear that temperature varies according to height, and based on that concept we are getting four different layers of atmosphere. But not only temperature, this structure also depends on different gases and their quantity or amount. Yes, we know maximum gases, heavier gases are found in the lower layer of atmosphere. But in higher level of atmosphere, lighter gases are found. So density also varies. So on the basis of that concept, density, we are getting these structures. But main one is temperature. And based on temperature, atmosphere is divided into these four layers. Number one, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, and thermosphere. Thermosphere means it's a layer where temperature is very, very high. And this layer also divided into two parts, ionosphere and exosphere. And in between two layers, if you follow troposphere and stratosphere, one more thin layer is present called tropopause. Again, stratosphere, mesosphere, another thin layer called stratopause. And mesosphere, thermosphere, one more layer is there, mesopause. These three layers actually are very thin. They are called transitional zone. This thin layer helps to differentiate between troposphere and stratosphere. So tropopause, stratopause and mesopause, these three thin layers we are getting, and you can say these three layers also indicate upper limit of each layer, means troposphere. What is the upper limit of troposphere? Tropopause. Then stratosphere. Then what is the upper limit of stratosphere? Stratopause. Like that way. Then mesosphere. Upper limit of mesosphere? Mesopause. Like this way we are getting whole structure of atmosphere. Now I am going to say one by one about each layer. First, troposphere. This word has derived from a Greek word tropos, means turning. Turning means in this layer all climatic calamities are found, because in this layer many gases are present, all constituents of atmosphere present, cloud, rain, snow, everything form here. So this layer is called turning layer, means weather changes can take place in this layer. This layer extends from surface to 18 kilometers in equatorial area and from surface to 8 kilometers in polar areas. Why? These two different extensions we are getting because of the shape of Earth. Here temperature condition, I have given two arrows, temperature decreasing, here increasing height. Just now I have given example plain and mountain. If you go higher altitude, temperature decreases. But average temperature of this layer is around 57 degrees centigrade. Because maximum people will live in the plain area, and plain area average temperature 57 degrees centigrade. But high altitude, it decreases. And it has one rate. If you move 1 kilometer distance, if you move upward 1 kilometer one, then 6.5 degree centigrade temperature will be reduced. This is the rate to decreasing temperature in this troposphere layer. Our next layer, that one is stratosphere, very important layer, because in this layer more ozone gas, means the concentration of ozone is high in this layer. And I told you what is the importance of ozone. It can protect us from ultraviolet rays from sun. So here the maximum concentration of ozone is found. And this layer extends from 18 kilometer to 50 kilometer. And the concentration of ozone more, it absorbs UV rays. That's why here temperature increases with increasing height. And after stratosphere, our next layer is mesosphere. In between upper limit stratopause is found there, then mesosphere. Mesosphere extends from 50 kilometer to 80 kilometer. And this layer is called the coldest layer, because here temperature decreasing with increasing height, and the lowest temperature figure is minus 90 degrees centigrade. Here meteorites completely burn up in this layer, it's so cold. Our next layer, thermosphere. So in between mesosphere and thermosphere, another transitional zone, mesopause, that is the upper limit of mesosphere. Then we are getting thermosphere, you can say the hottest layer. That layer is divided into two different parts or layers. One is ionosphere, another is exosphere. Ionosphere extends from 80 kilometer to 480 kilometer. And here temperature always increasing with increasing height. And the temperature average figure I have mentioned, 1480 degrees centigrade, means very high. What are the characteristics of this layer, ionosphere? Here ions form, means charged particles which are called ions are found in this layer. And the importance one is, this layer makes radio transmission possible on the Earth's surface. The radio waves transmitted from the Earth are reflected back to the Earth from this ionosphere. So that is the important characteristics of ionosphere. Another feature we can see due to this layer, that is a kind of light during night in the pole areas, North Pole or South Pole, whatever you can say. So from North Pole or from South Pole, you can see light during night. Why? Because charged particles are present here, so light can reflect from this layer, which we can see during night also, and that light is called aurora borealis from North Pole and aurora australis from South Pole. And after ionosphere, we are getting one more hottest layer, that is exosphere. Exosphere actually extends up to 980 km and gradually merges with interplanetary space. Here temperature is very high, around 1600 degrees centigrade, and it is very thin layer. Comparatively, each layer, if we compare, many layers are there, this one is very thin layer. You can say it is the outermost layer of the atmosphere, and very light weighted gases are found in this layer, like helium, hydrogen, etc. So this is exosphere. So these are all layers of atmosphere called structure of atmosphere. One importance of this tropopause transitional zone is, I missed that one, this layer free from any kind of climatic calamities. No rain, no storm, nothing. That's why this line, this transitional zone, this layer is very important for airlines, aircraft, because it is free from any climatic conditions. So these are the all structures of atmosphere and their importance. Here I want to show you one thing. One diagram has given based on structure of atmosphere, of the atmosphere, and in the book, just now you see, here given radio waves form in mesosphere layer, which is not correct, it's a wrong. Just now I said radio waves form or found in ionosphere layer, done, because of the presence of ions. So here it has shown in which layer? Mesosphere. It is not correct. So when you will practice this diagram, you will draw these radio waves in which layer? Ionosphere. Which one? Just now I said, here it is wrong. Understood? Our next topic, the biosphere. But students, one more topic is there, which one I missed, importance of the atmosphere. I have mentioned page number on page 22, importance of atmosphere given, and I am going to say about it, importance of atmosphere. Already I said many things about atmosphere, different gases and their uses I said. So from that side you will get some points about importance of the atmosphere, like atmosphere protect us from extreme heat which coming from sun. Then you can say it protect us from ultraviolet rays. Then you can say atmosphere gives us oxygen to breathe. Then you then you can say it gives us carbon dioxide, which important for plant to make their food. Then you can say it acts as, atmosphere acts as a greenhouse. That's why during night our earth is still warm. So these are the few points, few importance. It protects us from falling meteors. So many are there. I mentioned page number 22, and I think many of you know about it, what are the importance of atmosphere. So you have to prepare importance of the atmosphere. Now, and the last topic, that is the biosphere. Biosphere, what is the meaning? Actually, biosphere word has derived from a Greek word, that is bios, and the meaning of this word is life sphere. That's why this sphere is called the sphere of life or the layer of life. So we human beings and all living organisms are coming under this layer, biosphere. This biosphere can survive on the earth's surface because of the three layers. One of them is atmosphere, and next two, lithosphere and hydrosphere. Or in another way you can say, when atmosphere, lithosphere and hydrosphere, they meet, the biosphere form. So the biosphere can exist on the earth's surface, can survive on this earth because of all these three layers. And the meaning of the biosphere is the sphere of life or the layer of life. Next, then our last part, that is homework part. I have given only two homeworks. First one is one diagram, structure of atmosphere. I have mentioned page number on 21, it has given, you can see and draw, but with proper leveling. And one thing just now I have mentioned about radio wave, keep in your mind that one when you will draw. And the last one is from discuss the following box, that page number also I have mentioned, 23, one box given, discuss the following box. There are 6 questions given. 1, 2, 3 will write in your copy, and question number 4, 5, 6 you can write in your book. Understood? From the discuss the following box on page 23, which one given, from there question number 1, 2, 3 you will write in your copy, and question number 4, 5, 6 you can write in your book. Understood? So now this much means today I have said about the first part, which one already I have mentioned. We will discuss the second part in our next video. Thank you.